Asus absolutely wowed us with the Zephyrus G14. It was thin, light, and one of the most powerful gaming notebooks we'd ever seen. But I never got around to testing the G15, the slightly larger version, last year. That basically took everything we loved about the G14 and put it in a 15-inch gaming notebook package. So that sounds like a surefire winner, right? After testing out the 2021 edition of the Zephyrus G15, it's clearer than ever to me that Asus has kind of figured out the mystery of creating really solid premium gaming laptops. Now, it's worth remembering that it really wasn't always this way for Asus. They've been making gaming laptops for years, and the first Zephyrus, which we really like, you know, showed a lot of promise, but it was also very clearly one of the first thin and light premium gaming laptops. It had a GTX 1080, which was amazing at the time, and weighing under 5 pounds, that was also a pretty significant milestone, but it had practically no battery life, a terrible keyboard. It just wasn't really practical for a lot of people. Over the last few years, Asus has just refined its gaming laptop formula, especially for the Zephyrus line, and I think they really perfected it with the G14 last year. That thing weighed just 3.5 pounds. It was incredibly fast, and it actually got pretty decent battery life too for a gaming notebook. So onto the G15 now. Of course, it can't be nearly as light as the G14, it's a bigger machine after all, but it still weighs 4.2 pounds, which is pretty competitive when it comes to 15-inch gaming laptops. The Razer Blade and many others typically weigh around 4.5 pounds these days. It's also just as impressive as the G14 design-wise. It has a sturdy magnesium aluminum case, which just really feels good to hold, and the top part of the case also has this dot matrix design that just looks really cool. That's also kind of functional too. Asus filled those dots with like a prismatic paint material, so it just shimmers as you move the laptop around. But also, some models can actually have LEDs in that lid, and you can put images and little animated GIFs and stuff. I didn't get a chance to test that out, but that was something Asus demoed last year with the G14 before CES. Under the hood, the G15 features AMD's Ryzen 9 5900HS processor, NVIDIA's RTX 30 series GPUs, and an optional 1440p Quad HD display running at 165 Hz with G-Sync and FreeSync support. It's one of the first gaming laptops to rock AMD's new hardware, and to me, that alone makes it a particularly compelling purchase. We're still waiting for Intel to release its faster H-Series 11th gen laptop CPUs. Right now, they're just limited to 4 cores, and they're really more meant for ultra-portable gaming laptops. So if you want to future-proof yourself a bit, the Ryzen 9 system, any of AMD's new Zen 3 hardware, would be a better investment. Our review unit included NVIDIA's RTX 3080 GPU and that 1440p screen, which together just feels like a very nice and complementary pairing there. When I reviewed the MSI GS66, I mentioned that 1440p is just a really compelling option for gaming laptops, and it's popping up in more and more machines this year. It offers more sharpness and, you know, more pixels than typical 1080p displays, and also it's just a little more practical than a 4K display on a gaming laptop. If you like to game natively, and that is have games running at the full resolution of the display, which typically looks best, 4K is really hard to power. You waste a lot of power just trying to get games up to that. I think 1440p for most people is a really nice middle ground. So with that combination of hardware, when I was mowing down bad guys in Destiny 2 or jumping between Overwatch rounds, everything just looked really silky smooth, and that's exactly what I want from a gaming laptop like this. And when I was able to take a breath, it was also easy to see that, you know, the G15's 1440p screen just delivered a little more sharpness, especially around fine edges, things that kind of bother me on 1080p screens, no matter how fast those refresh rates get. While the Zephyrus G14 was more than powerful enough to deliver over 100 frames per second in both of those games, what really mattered more to me was how it felt, and it just felt very good. The screen just instantly kept up with whatever I was doing. I felt like I had an extra advantage during really frenetic firefights, but it was also really useful during slower sequences where I had to like slow down and look through a sniper scope. Just being able to refresh the screen faster gives you more control and more precision, which could really, you know, make or break a match for you. Basically, what I'm saying is that having a high refresh rate screen and, you know, variable refresh rate technology that can synchronize your display with whatever frame rate you're at is kind of like the gaming equivalent of hearing a symphony in perfect harmony. Now, it's worth pointing out the G15 doesn't have the fastest 1440p screen we've seen. That MSI GS66 went all the way up to 240Hz, but I don't think that's really gonna matter for most people. Unless you're an aspiring esports player or something, you're probably not even gonna notice the difference between 120Hz and beyond. Just like we saw with NVIDIA's RTX 2080 GPU though, don't expect the same exact speeds between the desktop and mobile parts. And in particular, the 3080 just didn't feel as beefy as what I saw on my gaming desktop. In our review unit, even the RTX 3080 kind of struggled with Cyberpunk 2077 with 1440p maxed out graphics and the highest ray tracing settings. It chugged along between 40 and 45 FPS, which is playable, I guess, but on a gaming laptop like this, that's not really what I want. And in that case, even NVIDIA's DLSS technology, which renders a game at a lower resolution and uses AI to kind of upscale things, didn't really help the performance very much. Towards the end, I just settled on playing Cyberpunk with medium ray tracing settings and DLSS turned on to get 55 to 63 FPS. That's pretty smooth, especially when you're comparing it to console performance. When it comes to benchmarks, the Zephyrus G15 outperformed MSI's GS66 and Geekbench 5's multi-core score, but otherwise the two laptops were fairly neck and neck. Their 3DMark TimeSpy Extreme numbers were practically identical. That may just be a sign of how much Intel caught up with AMD's performance last year, since the MSI notebook is powered by last year's 10th generation Intel CPU. Under load, the G15's fans were noticeable, but not nearly as annoying as the GS66's, so that was really nice. The battery life was pretty impressive too. I got 8 hours and 50 minutes in our benchmark, which wasn't nearly as impressive as the near 13 hours I got with the G14, but still it was almost half an hour more than the GS66. Now, a gaming laptop needs more than just powerful hardware. It also has to actually feel good to play on. And thankfully, Asus's keyboard still works really well. It has a healthy 1.7 millimeters of travel, so there's a lot of clickiness, a lot of responsiveness, and sure, it's not mechanical like what we're gonna see on the upcoming Alienwares, which are gonna have Cherry MX keyboards, but it still feels pretty solid to me. I also appreciate that the keyboard is still pretty quiet too, so it doesn't sound super clicky, which means you can bring this notebook into a classroom or an office and not really distract everybody. The trackpad is also pretty solid. It's large, it's a glass trackpad. It is smooth and accurate. It's great for productivity tasks and just browsing around the web. Mostly, I'm just glad it's not shoved off to the right side of the keyboard like Asus has been doing with so many other laptops. Asus rarely skimps on connectivity with its gaming machines too, and the G15 is no exception. It features an HDMI port, Ethernet, USB 3.2 Type-A connections, USB-C, and a microSD card slot. Personally, I'd still like to see a full-size SD card slot, but I suppose at this point, it's easy enough to use microSD in cameras and other devices, so laptop makers are just putting in the smaller port to make things easier for them. And yes, there is one missing major accessory on the G15, just like the G14, there's no webcam. And honestly, I'll say that didn't really bug me too much while I was testing it, but the problems do arise when, you know, you consider that we're pretty much always on Zoom calls these days. Having a built-in camera is just nice if you're far off and away from your desk and you just want to quickly be on video with somebody. Personally, I think a lot of gamers already have, you know, nice external cameras that they're using for streaming or for, you know, more high quality settings, but maybe moving forward, Asus should just put a cheap camera in the box to give people an option there. The Zephyrus G15 currently starts at $1,499 with an RTX 3060 and 16GB of RAM. That's not too bad considering it still has the Ryzen 9 and a speedy 1440p display. Our review unit sells for $2,500 with the RTX 3080 and 32GB of RAM, but I'm not quite sure that's worth the $1,000 premium. The 3060 will still deliver excellent Quad HD performance and has more than enough memory for gaming and streaming simultaneously. Once again, Asus is offering a significant value for the price, considering that the latest Razer Blade starts at $1,700 with an RTX 3060 and a 1080p 144Hz screen. Saving $200 for a better screen seems like just a no-brainer to me. It all really boils down to this for me. The Zephyrus G15 just has everything I want in a gaming laptop. It's powerful, it's relatively lightweight, and it's not super expensive either. Even if it doesn't have a webcam, I don't think that's a huge issue for a lot of people. Get an external webcam, you'll have better performance anyway. For most gamers, I think the Zephyrus G15 is kind of a dream machine. Stay tuned to Engadget.com for more gaming laptop reviews. If you dug this video, be sure to like and subscribe.